the Wadden Sea, one of the most remarkable places on Earth. Between its sumptuous shorelines and dynamic waters, life bustles. It offers feeding and breeding grounds for countless animals that live and visit here. Continuously adapting, this large tidal flat system is vital to biodiversity on a global scale. For this outstanding universal value and relevance, the Wadden Sea was put on UNESCO's World Heritage List. But with the speed of climate change and current heat waves, the system struggles to keep up, and future scenarios vary. Imagine arriving at your top feeding ground only to find out that your favorite food is already off the menu. The warmer waters in winter have invited shrimp much earlier in the season, allowing them to feast on juvenile clams, still small enough to be eaten. This shift in timing disturbs the natural feeding rhythm. It drastically diminishes the migrating wader birds' much-needed sustenance. Another threat is sea level rise. As essential feeding grounds submerge, good spots become hard to find. Once found, the animals face a lot more challenges. And competition. Without sufficient food for fueling, migration to their breeding grounds several thousand kilometers away becomes uncertain. Birds and clams are not the only ones that are struggling. Several fish species depend on the Wadden Sea's freshwater connections to spawn. Droughts caused by climate change stop freshwater flowing from the hinterland to the sea. At the same time, remaining freshwater is stored and used inland. Not able to enter the rivers, these fish are left with no place to spawn. Though the future looks dire, we can act now to help the Wadden Sea adapt to these challenges. Most importantly, we must give room to natural dynamics as much as possible. When we relieve the Wadden Sea from other main stresses, such as disturbance and pollution, we allow the system more capacity to adapt to the impact of climate change to ensure its resilience. In addition, we must make sure that the Wadden Sea stays well connected with other migration areas. Free-flowing freshwater systems, even in times of drought, allow fish to complete their life cycles. Measures like these are just a start. Engaging these challenges requires collaboration, ambition, and system thinking from all of us. So let's start now to safeguard our world heritage for the next generations.